So some of you have asked in the comment section, why did I choose marine engineering? Or why did I choose to become an engineer instead of a deck officer, a navigator? And a lot of you have asked, why does PMMA look like a military school when it's a school for merchant marine? As a fourth class, you are the lowest ranking cadet there. Well, basically, you're not allowed to relax. Hello everyone and welcome back to my podcast. So on the last episode, I've told you about how I started my seafaring career, how I entered PMMA, and a few details about my first shipboard assignment. So some of you have asked in the comment section, why did I choose marine engineering? Or why did I choose to become an engineer instead of a deck officer, a navigator? The honest answer to that, again, my first choice was nautical, to be a deck officer. But as I mentioned, PMMA is quite strict. So during the medical evaluation, there's this thing for the eyesight. Okay? They test for the eyesight and the color blindness test. Now, in order to qualify for deck, you have to have 20/20 vision, which I also had back then. I had 20/20 vision back then. And you have to perfect the color blindness test, what they call the Ishihara test. Okay, so for me, I had one mistake in the Ishihara test. This is a test wherein there's a booklet for each page. There are numbers printed within a pattern of color. Okay, and you have to make out what that number is. And the nurse actually flips it. You only have like 1 second for each page. You have to answer very quickly. And it was my first time to take that kind of examination. So I made one mistake. I actually did not make a mistake. I hesitated on one page. Okay. The pattern was, I think if I remember correctly, something like 74. It looked like 24 to me, but I was doubting it, that it might be 74. So I hesitated for a moment, and then the nurse flipped the page. That's it. They counted that as one mistake. So when the results came, they informed me that I'm not qualified to enroll for nautical. Okay, so I had two choices. One is I shift and enroll to engineering because I'm still qualified. I had 20/20 vision and just one mistake in the Ishihara test still qualifies me for the engineering. Or the second choice is I take the examinations again next year. So what the hell was I going to do for a whole year? Work at McDonald's or something like that? That's going to be a massive waste of time. And as I mentioned in the previous episode, what I wanted was to finish college as quickly as possible and go to work. So back then, I really had no clue. As I mentioned, I had no clue what seafaring was. And I really didn't know what the difference between a deck officer and an engine officer was back then. I merely asked, is the salary going to be the same? Is the salary of a fourth engineer and a third mate the same? They said, yes, it's pretty much the same. Well, that was good enough for me. Engineering it is. Anyway, I didn't mind actually because I was technically inclined even way back then. In high school, I actually went to Don Bosco Technical Institute in Makati. So I've had experience in a lot of technical subjects. I've had machine shop, drafting, computer programming, a little bit of electrical works. I found all of that interesting even when I was a kid. So yeah, I didn't mind going to engineering because engineering is a good fit for me. Now, I have mentioned that when I entered PMMA, okay, and went through the orientation period, I mentioned the term survive. Okay. Even when I became a fourth classman for the whole year, I survived the fourth class year. And a lot of you have asked, why does PMMA look like a military school when It's a school for Merchant Marine. If you haven't already watched my videos about PMMA, the simple answer to that is that all graduates are required to be commissioned as officers, reservist officers in the Philippine Navy. And of course, to be commissioned, you have to undergo training. So it is part of the curriculum. It's actually kind of a trade-off since we were government scholars. Well, it's only fair that we give something in return, right? I mean, the government pretty much pays for almost everything, for almost all of our school expenses, including board and lodging and meals. So the least we could do is to train to become reservists. And over the years, a lot of alumni from PMMA have chosen active service. A few of my classmates actually entered the Philippine Navy and the Philippine Coast Guard a few years after they have worked on board the Merchant Marine. One of them is a Coast Guard captain right now, and I guess pretty soon he's going to be promoted to Commodore. And he's basically the same age as I am, 44, 45 years old. In any case, the Academy provides its graduates with many career options. And, well, if you ask me, I'd rather have a lot of options at such a young age than having myself limited to just one. Now, I've talked about surviving the fourth class year. Again, as I mentioned, as a fourth class, you are the lowest ranking cadet there. You don't have the third class within the campus, within the academy, because they're on their shipboard training year. But you have the second class and the first class, the third years and the fourth years, and they are your seniors, your upperclassmen, and you live with them in campus. So seniority is actually a very big thing in PMMA. You have to obey whatever their lawful orders are. And being in the fourth class, you have to follow certain protocols, certain traditions, like standing at attention exaggeratedly. You see that they're almost bending backwards, right? And you always have to move on the double. Move very fast, move on double time. You have to run all the time. You're not allowed to walk. You're not allowed to smile. You're not allowed to eat snacks or eat between meals. Well, basically, you're not allowed to relax. The reason behind this is that you're actually being placed in a very uncomfortable position. And you're being trained to become comfortable in an uncomfortable situation. On board a ship, as well as generally in life, there will always be uncomfortable situations. And on board a ship, it's kind of magnified, these things, because of your distance from everyone. And I've seen a lot of seafarers from other schools break down, especially during their first contract. They were not prepared. They did not know what to expect. They cry. They want to go home even just after a few days of being on board. Yeah, it's basically a mental breakdown. PMMA does not want to produce graduates who are like that. So basically, this is one of the methods wherein the Academy weeds out, well, no other word for it, the weak. And for those who are actually determined, it's training them to be comfortable in such situations, to be stable even under immense pressure, to keep their presence of mind even though they are under severe stress. And your upperclassmen will do all that for you. I mean, they are the ones who are going to enforce all of these traditions. They're going to be the eyes that monitor you constantly. They won't give you any chance to relax. If they see you relaxing, that's already an offense. They're going to punish you. Usually calisthenics or other stuff. So you do that for basically an entire school year until you get recognized, until the end of the school year when you get recognized as a third class midshipman. Now, there was a question in the comment section. What motivated me to survive? Was it my family or was it ego? But that's a story for the next episode. Once again, thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next one.